Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 15 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now in the previous video I showed you guys how to do audio-video crossfading, and in today's video I want to show you guys how you can do a wipe transition. Now you guys may know wipe transitions from things like Star Wars, where we have like an iris that is expanding outward and showing us another scene, or we're having a clock that is exposing a new scene, or we have a swipe to the left or right or up and down. We can do all those things really easily with the Blender program. And really, all the things that you guys learned when we were doing the fade in, fade out, and when we were doing the crossfading of video, it pretty much requires that you do similar things. So let's actually cut up these strips that we have here so that we can actually set them up for doing a wipe. So let's just make a cut anywhere. And we're going to go down to the strip menu, and we're going to do a soft cut. And remember, guys, always do a soft cut if you know that you're going to be doing any type of transition, because you can make adjustments very easily. So now let's actually select our strips here. And remember, just like with the crossfade and with the fade in and fade out, we need to make sure that the strips that are being wiped between actually share frames. They have to have at least one frame in common in order for this to work. So let's just set it, we'll eye it, and there we go, that should work fine. And you guys remember in the last video I showed you how you can actually set up your frame range so that we can just continuously play this back and we can actually view changes. So I'm going to do that same thing. I'm going to select the area I want my frame range to start for the playback, and I'm going to go down here and I'm going to hit the S button to set the start frame that I want the playback to start at. And I'm going to set it somewhere after here. There we go. And we're going to hit E, and that will make it playback this section continuously. Now right now you guys can see that it's just skipping from strip to strip. It doesn't have any kind of transition, and it's not even transitioning the audio. So what do we need to do next? Well, we need to select the video strips in the order that we want the wipe to happen, just like we did with the crossfade and with the fade in, fade out. So we want to select this strip first. We want to hold the shift button down and select this strip. Now we just go down to add, and we go down to effect strip, and we select wipe. Okay, so you can see that we actually have a wipe strip up here on channel 5. And let's actually zoom in on that with our box zoom, and I'll hold my shift button down and hit the B button, and we'll draw the box over the area we want to actually zoom in on, and that makes it much easier for us to see the area that we're going to be playing back and reviewing. So now when I select the wipe strip, we can go over to the properties for the wipe strip, and you'll notice that we have a section called effect strip, and it has a transition set to single. And this will just do a standard basic single wipe. So let's actually put the green line right before this so we can see what this looks like. I'll hit the play button, and you can see it's actually wiping downward in this transition. Let's actually close in the frame range so that we can repeat this much better. So I'm going to actually select the green line here, go down here, hit S to place the start there, and click the green line here, and go down here and hit E. And now this will actually repeat this over and over again. Let's see. Okay, so you can see that's what that looks like. And we can switch it to a different type of transition simply by selecting a different option in this transition drop-down box. So we have a clock, we have an iris, we have double, and we have single. Let me just do each of those so you can see what they look like. So we'll hit play. Here's double. Here's iris. Here is clock. And you'll notice down here we have a direction. So let's change the direction by switching it to in. That's pretty cool. Now, something else I want to show you guys is that you can actually blur the line on some of these transitions. You'll notice that when you switch the transition drop-down to certain options, for example, if we switch it to the double, if we switch it to the single, we have this option for blur width and angle. So this is really cool because we can actually make the line of the, that is breaking up the two different videos blurry. Let me show you what that looks like. We're gonna just turn that up. You can actually look at the preview window right now and see how it looks when I actually turn the blur width up. And let's actually play that back and see what that looks like. It's pretty cool. Let's try it with a different one. Let's do a double. So you see, you can actually change this blur width. And we can also change the angle of the transition. So let's actually play with that. I'm going to actually turn the blur width down so you can see it easier. Check that out. You can make it actually wipe that direction. Let's actually switch it to there. That gives you a nice diagonal wipe. I think that's all I really need to tell you guys about today. That's how you do wipe transitions. See you guys in the next video.